Hello and welcome everybody, I'm Necromanticer and today we're going to be playing Prison Architect. Right now I have my maintenance workers set up to build a fence around the entire perimeter of the prison, and that should give me a little bit of time to explain what exactly is going on here. Prison Architect is a very interesting little management game where you are tasked with creating a functional prison and keeping all your inmates in check while at the same time caring for all their needs and making sure they don't really spark into insurrection and start killing your people. What's going to be going on here is I and Phoenix, I've already collaborated with him once, but we're going to be creating a sort of collaborative let's play of this game. We're going to be passing the save file back and forth between him and I, and all the while trying to work within the parameters that each of us set up in each episode. So, as you can see, he had already set up this wonderful little basis for the prison. He hadn't quite enclosed it yet, but I've got my maintenance workers working on that right now. That should really help with escapees and whatnot, so we've got that going on. And he also created the foundation for pretty much everything we're going to need to get this prison at least accepting new inmates. It's not quite ready for that just yet, but with a little bit of work, we can set this up to be right as rain and ready to actually hold inmates, whereas right now they would pretty much all just walk away since we have no doors or cells ready for them. So, first things first, let's start spending our money on creating their actual cell blocks. At first, we're only going to be taking in about 8 in order to get the prison up and running. But after that, we can start expanding into more cell blocks and creating more spaces for these prisoners. Another thing we're going to want to do right away is create office space for our workers. Namely, we're going to be wanting to get a warden as soon as we can in order to get him to begin researching some bureaucracy. Bureaucracy is basically research in this game in that it allows you access to different mechanics, items, rooms, and all sorts of good stuff. But in order to begin bureaucracy, we need to have a warden who requires an office in order to function, along with most of the other individual staff members. And so we have a nice little office block set up that's going to be able to accommodate all 4 of the specialists of the staff members, and so since it needs an office desk, chair, and filing cabinets, I set those up and have now separated that out into each individual room. The way Prison Architect works is that you can task your builders, namely your maintenance men, to work on things, and they will put individual items throughout your prison after they're delivered on these here trucks, which honestly will wait forever, but before they deliver anything more, I'm going to want to actually change up where they're delivering because I happen to build a fence right through the old delivery post. So let's move that on over some, move the garbage as well. And I'm going to want to turn off this utility in order to move the water pump indoors. Otherwise, when you dismantle a water pump, it sprays water everywhere. And when water touches a power station, horrible, horrible things happen, so we don't want that to be happening at all. There's also a very interesting system wherein the game actually differentiates between what's out of doors and indoors. It's kind of similar to how some games like RimWorld or Dwarf Fortress work, but not quite as intensive. And so it still has the same room designation mechanic where you can designate things like cells for prisoners to be harbored in, but they also are rather nice in that they tell you exactly what room requirements you're missing. So this is missing a bed and a toilet and a door, but we will be managing that soon enough as the maintenance workers are getting near the end of the line. Not quite there yet, but we've got quite a bit more work to be done. The main source of income is supposed to be prisoners, but in the early game you can't really accommodate that many, so instead you're going to be needing to access grants, which will give you a certain amount of startup money, called the advance payment, and a second larger, well, more sum of money, called the completion bonus, which you get for actually finishing off the requirements of the grant. And so right now we have the Basic Detention Center and Administration Center grants, which will give us about 15,000 monies at their completion. And with that, we are building up the basis of the prison. As I said, we've got some work to be done all around. The cells are going to take a little while to set up, but in the meantime, we can also start working on other things. The holding cell is actually complete, but I'm going to want to add shower heads and actual plumbing to this shower in order to make it functional and allow prisoners to clean up after themselves, because every prisoner is going to have an individual set of needs that we're going to need to fulfill in order for them to be happy and not start insurrecting on us, which is very, very bad and can lead to all sorts of nasty things, not least of which a financial penalty for having a, quote, incident. When you're not having incidents, you slowly get a larger and larger amount of grant money from the government, and that can be quite nice for having sort of a supplementary income in addition to all of your prisoners. For the moment, since we have no actual staff besides these maintenance workers, we actually have a positive daily cash flow, but once we've actually set everything up, that's going to diminish quite fast until we can actually get some prisoners involved. And that is going to take a little bit more preparation yet. As you can see, there's a plumbing system in which you actually need to provide water to... Oh, since I'm going to be moving this, I'm probably not going to want the little pipes to go there, but you have a plumbing system in which you actually need to provide water to individual utilities, and prisoners can actually take advantage of that and start tunneling through these piping in order to hopefully escape if they play their cards just right, but we're probably going to be managing to avoid that quite nicely. I know how that mechanic works, so I can prepare in advance for it. It comes a little bit out of left field on your first playthrough, but I think that's how most games should be, is that they come out of left field, and that you kind of want to have players learning mechanics as they play a game, not just have everything laid barren for them from the very beginning. As you can see, I'm connecting all of these individual showerheads to the master pipeline, and that's going to mean that they have water, can actually provide water to the prisoners who are going to be showering there. And now that I've got my water pump station moved, I can switch the power back on. As you can see, it has a certain level of power that is determined by how many lights and other utilities you have running off of the same power station. And you can increase that by adding capacitors for quite a hefty chunk of money, 1,000 monies each. But that shouldn't be a problem since we have at least 25,000 to work with, though we do have quite a few other things that we're going to need to be spending our money on. Namely, kitchen supplies, for one. We're going to want to prepare a kitchen with a set of cookers, fridges, and a sink in order for our prisoners to actually be fed at all. And, of course, you're going to need a serving table and actual tables for them to sit at once you have your kitchen set up. So we're going to set this up over here and designate the rooms. This is going to be a fairly large canteen. It's actually very nice how Phoenix set this up, because overall this entire room is about the perfect size for a maximum sized kitchen, and so we will have some room to expand the prison as time goes on. I'm just going to designate a few more of these side rooms that we are going to be inputting later. Not quite equipping just yet, but any sorts of rooms that I want to have set up for when I actually take the time to kit them out. That way I can just quickly mouse over them and reference what exactly they are going to need to complete the requirements. This kitchen is going to require a few benches so that prisoners can actually sit at these tables. And we also have a common room right here, which has no necessary requirements, but it's best in order to keep your prisoners happy to actually put in some luxuries and ways for them to entertain themselves, because as I'm sure you can guess, prison is not too entertaining. So we're gonna give them a couple of phone booths for them to kind of talk to their family, a pool table, a bench to watch the matches, and a pair of televisions for them to just relax in. It is a common room. It's basically the R&R room. It's where prisoners go for a little bit of recreation on their free time. And now that these cells all have their proper setup, we can run the actual pipelines to them and close them off with doors, and now they're fully functioning cells, and you can see my prisoner capacity up here in the top right-hand corner. In addition to actually having very basic requirements, these grants also generally require you to have a certain amount of staff. Namely, I have this kitchen here that... Oh, did I build fridges instead of cookers? That was a mistake on my part. I thought I'd switch to cookers, but... Let's swap these in there as soon as we can get those dismantled. As you can see, everything has a build time and a dismantle time, which is balanced against your number of maintenance workers. You can hire more, but the starter 8 is generally enough to get you through most situations. But now we have all the requirements except for a pair of guards and a pair of cooks. So by hiring those two sets of workers, we can actually get the grant money and start taking other grants, because grants actually can only be taken two at a time, and while we can get some bureaucracy to increase that number, we don't have that yet. So let's start working on our bureaucracy. Get the warden involved, and we can now spend money to research things. Since our other grant requires we hire an accountant and unlock finance, that's what I'm going to want to do first, but we're also going to need maintenance, security, and health, which will be researched one at a time, but I'm going to need them all, so I want to get them all queued up in order for my warden to work on those as he progresses. And so we have the kitchen, common room, basically all the prisoners' necessities set up. Now it's time to start thinking about a few other things like the visitation. You can set up visitation tables, and prisoners can visit with their family. That takes care of some of their needs and keeps them generally happy. And I'm also going to want to equip this staff room with some vending machines and just some things to relax, namely a pair of wide sofas, a bookshelf, just some things to keep my staff from being overworked and dissatisfied. So we can set that all up. This room over here is eventually going to be expanded over and turned into an infirmary, but I don't have health unlocked just yet, so I can't actively begin that research. I'm going to set up a few more of these tables just so that I can know exactly where everything's going to go in the future. I'm not going to equip them just yet, but I want them to be there kind of holding the place, since they're very cheap and can be built in short order, and that'll help me in planning out the rest of the prison. Because I'm also going to want to have a laundry for my prisoners connected to this canteen here, because I already have the water running there. Now, let me just check out with the planning tool that allows you to decide without actually building where exactly you're going to want things. And since this is going to be the infirmary, it's going to take some hospital beds. And so I want to make sure that I have room for about 5 of those. As you can see, we had the forest option turned on when we created the prison, which means that the prison populated with a little bit of trees, which take a little while for your maintenance workers to clear out, but they also drop logs, which can be sold for a bit of supplementary income early on into the game. Let's crack a door open into this laundry here, and let's see, is there anything else that we direly need? I don't think so, so let's open up our prison to accepting prisoners, because the first shipment is always going to be 8 prisoners, and we have capacity for them. Let's see, is there anything else? I need to finally hire the financier and begin her own research. Hire her and head over into the bureaucracy. We can unlock an extra grant, allowing us to take 3 on at once. And I'm also going to take on tax relief, which will increase our daily income by about 15%, if I'm not mistaken, which is very useful for getting in the early game, especially because it takes forever to research. So this is just about nicely set up. We're going to want to expand into a few offices for psychologists over here in the future, maybe with a morgue attached to this infirmary, and start setting up some actual flooring and perhaps expanding the cell blocks. But for now, we are just about set to take in prisoners, and everything is right as rain. So thank you so much for watching. I think I'm going to be cutting it right around here. I've been having quite a fun time with this game, and it's really interesting how the development cycle is running. I really encourage you all to give it a look, and we'll be bringing you more of this newest alpha as time progresses. So thank you so much for watching, and have a nice day.